boys and girls, and welcome to Bible Storytime. It is so good to be with you once again. I hope that you are having a wonderful start to this new year and that you are blessed by the Lord and enjoying your families and your brothers and sisters and your moms and dads and just being blessed. I miss you very much and I can't wait to be together with you again. But until that time, we will continue doing our lessons through the computer. What a blessing we have. And this is our color page, and you can download it from our website. And it says the letter A. And we are going to take a journey through the alphabet, and we are going to commit God's word to memory. That is something that we are going to work on this year, this 2021. One of my goals for 2021, memorizing God's word and teaching you how to do it too. So, as you can see here, there's a little girl in this picture and it says, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. This will be our memory verse for this week. So every day, I would like you to practice it. All have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Now, we are going to learn about this verse. We're going to learn what it means, and we're going to see through Adam how we have all sinned. Okay, boys and girls, our verse, Romans 3:23. All have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Now, all, do you know what that means? All means exactly what it sounds like. It means everyone. It means you and me, your mom and dad, your brothers and sisters, your uncles and aunts and grandpas and grandmas, your cousins, all, A-L-L, all. That means everyone. All have sinned. Sinned, what is that? What is that word, sinned? We have sinned, all have sinned. Well, I'm gonna get up and kind of show you what that means. Now, sin is an idea of missing the mark, of not getting it quite right, not doing it right. So if you can think of sin like a mark, something you have to hit, like this bullseye right here. Now, we, as we live our lives, are to hit the mark. The only person to ever hit the mark is Jesus. And we know that Jesus was perfect and flawless. He made no mistakes. Well, I miss the mark. I sin. You miss the mark. You sin. Every person that walks this earth misses the mark. We all don't get the bullseye all the time. You see, God's standard is perfection, holiness. God is holy, holy, holy. He hits the mark. Jesus hits the mark, but we don't. And so if I take my little arrow here and I attempt to hit the bullseye, I hope I don't damage anything. Oh, I missed it. I got here. I missed the mark. The mark is here. That's sin. I didn't get it quite right. And it doesn't matter how close I get, I missed it. Let's try that again. I'm going to try and hit the mark. Oh, sin. I missed the mark. Now, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. All miss the mark. Now, to fall short is just like missing the mark. We miss, we fail. We don't obtain, we don't reach it, we don't get it. We fall short. Now, God's standard is perfect holiness. He's glorious. I don't measure up. You don't measure up. We miss the mark. We sin. And we don't only just miss the mark. We also break God's laws. If God says don't lie and we lie, we break God's law. If God says honor your mother and father and we show them dishonor, by disobeying, by being rude, by being disrespectful, we again have missed the mark. We've sinned. We have broken God's law. Now, if the Bible says, do not steal, and I steal, I take something that is not mine, whether it's a pencil, a candy bar, a cookie, a toy from the toy store, or something from a friend. If I take it, or from my brother or sister, and it is not mine, I have stolen. I have broken God's law. So the verse from Romans 3:23 says, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. We all sin. We all miss the mark. We all break God's law. Just like Adam. Do you remember Adam and Eve from the book of Genesis? Oh, Adam and Eve enjoyed God and all that he had made in the Garden of Eden. They lived in paradise with a bounty of food, clean water, animals to name, animals to hang out with. They were to tend the earth, the garden. They were allowed to eat of every tree. Every fruit was theirs to enjoy, but one. God told Adam, do not eat of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. If you eat its fruit, you will surely die. Well, that all happened. And then we come to Genesis 3. And I'm going to read you the story of what we call the fall. Genesis 3. The serpent was the shrewdest of all the wild animals the Lord God had made. One day he asked the woman, did God really say you must not eat of the fruit from any of the trees in the garden? Of course we may eat from the trees in the garden, the woman replied. It's only the fruit from the tree in the middle of the garden that we are not allowed to eat. God said, you must not eat of it or even touch it. If you do, you will die. You won't die, the serpent replied to the woman. God knows that your eyes will be opened as soon as you eat it, and you will be like God, knowing both good and evil. You see this sly serpent, the crafty one in the garden? Well, he deceived Eve. First, he got her to question God's word. Then, he told her God was lying to her, that God was keeping something from her, that God was holding back from her. And she, well, she wanted to be like God, and she wanted to know good from evil, and oh, that fruit looks so good, and if I'm not gonna die, well, the woman was convinced, the Bible said. She saw that the tree was beautiful, and its fruit looked delicious. And she wanted the wisdom it would give her. So she took some of the fruit and she ate it. Then she gave some to her husband who was with her, and he ate it too. At that moment, their eyes were opened, and suddenly they felt shame. They were naked. So they sewed fig leaves together to cover themselves. You see, the woman, Eve, well, what did she do? She broke God's law. God told her, don't eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. You can eat anything else. Don't eat from that tree. The serpent came in his crafty and wily ways, and he convinced her, oh, God didn't say that. Oh, that won't happen. God knows if you eat it, you're going to be wise like he's wise. And doesn't it look so good? You see, he convinced her. He tricked her, and she took and she ate, and she didn't just take and eat and break God's law herself. She encouraged Adam to break God's law too. And he took, and he ate, and he broke God's law. And then their eyes were opened, and they realized what they had done, and they tried to cover it up. They tried to hide, and so they sewed fig leaves. And when the cool evening breezes were blowing, the man and his wife heard the Lord God walking about in the garden. And so they hid from the Lord God among the trees. Then the Lord God called to the man, where are you? He replied, I heard you walking in the garden, so I hid. I was afraid, Because I was naked.
Who told you that you were naked? The Lord God asked. Have you eaten from the tree whose fruit I commanded you not to eat? In other words, did you do what I told you not to do, Adam? The man replied, It was the woman you gave me. She gave me the fruit, and I ate it. Then the Lord God asked the woman, What have you done?
The serpent deceived me, she replied. That's why I ate it.
Then the Lord God said to the serpent, Because you have done this, you are cursed. More than all animals, domestic and wild, you will crawl on your belly, groveling in the dust as long as you live. Now, as we continue in the story, we learn that there are some punishments that God gives to Adam and Eve and to the serpent. The serpent will now crawl on his belly. That's why serpents slither. They crawl on their bellies. The woman would have pain in childbirth. And the man will have to till the ground. No longer it would just give its fruit to Adam like it had. He's going to now have to contend with thorns and thistles and weeds, and he will have to work by the sweat of his brow. They will struggle for a living, and they will have to work hard to tend the ground so that it would produce its fruit. You know, Adam and Eve chose to sin. They did wrong. They missed the mark. They disobeyed God, and they tried to hide, and they tried to blame each other. But you know what? God knew what they did. He saw them sin. He watched as they tried to hide. He listened as they blamed each other. They blamed the serpent, and they even blamed him. God heard, and he saw it all. And he has a plan. He's always had a plan. And the prophecy is in verse 15 when it says, And I will cause hostility between you and the woman and between your offspring and her offspring. He will strike your head and you will strike his heel. And we know ultimately this is the prophecy of Jesus one day and Satan and the Lord will crush him, which he did on the cross. God had a plan. And Romans 3:23 says, All have sinned and have fallen short of the glory of God. And we see that first sin of humanity in Adam. All have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. We all do wrong. We all make mistakes. We all miss the mark. We all willfully disobey at times, don't we? When God says don't and we do. When God says shh, don't say that and we do. When God says don't take that and we take it. Don't watch that and we watch that. Don't do that and we do that. We all err. And that is why God sent Jesus. We need him. We can't go to heaven and be in a relationship with God without Jesus. We need Jesus. And when we struggle to obey, when our day is hard, when it's hard to do the right thing, simply say, Jesus, please help me. I need you. I fall short of God's glory, and he will always help. And that's why he came. We can't do it on our own. We can't save ourselves. But Jesus can save us, and Jesus can help us. He never sinned, and he paid the penalty for all humanity on the cross. And so we can go to him for help, and he can help us. We can ask him for forgiveness, and he will forgive us. So the first verse this week that I want you to work on memorizing is for the letter A. A, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Let me see your hands. Open, shut them, open, shut them, give a little clap. Open, shut them, open, shut them, put them in your lap. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time that we've been able to spend in your word. And we thank you for the truth of Scripture that always leads us in the right path, that always lights our way and teaches us truth. And we thank you for your truth and that all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Because if we know that we've done wrong
and that we sin, then we can come to you and ask for forgiveness, and we can be cleansed and healed. So we thank you for the truth of your word that shows us our need for our Savior, Jesus. We thank you for this day, and we ask that you would help us memorize your word so that we do not sin against you. It's in your Son, Jesus' mighty name that we pray. Amen. I look forward to hearing you all recite your memory verses as you begin to learn God's word. May you have a blessed week. God bless you.